On October 10th, James Watt III was brought into our jail by Akron Police Department on drug-related charges. And while he was being booked, he admitted to using heroin. And at that point, you know, as we always do, we notify the medical staff, and they are put on our heroin protocol, which basically means they get their vital signs checked every 8 hours. The next evening, while his vital signs were being checked, the medical staff noticed that he was vomiting, and they contacted the doctor, and the doctor ordered a shot of Phenergan. The medical staff continued to monitor his vital signs, and at approximately 12:30 in the morning on the 12th, Watts was still vomiting, so the doctor ordered another shot of Phenergan. The medical staff continued to check his vitals, and the next day he was up, he was walking, he was talking to people, he was drinking liquids and eating, so he seemed to be improving, and deputies were continuing to check on him as they made their rounds. And at approximately 4 p.m. yesterday, another inmate tried to wake him up when he thought that Watts was sleeping. The inmate was unsuccessful. The inmate then notified a deputy, and the deputy contacted the medical staff. The jail nursing staff began treating Watts and contacted EMS personnel. And about 4:33 p.m., Akron EMS arrived and began to treat Watts. He was then transported to Akron General Medical Center, where he was pronounced dead at 5:06 p.m.
You said you followed procedure in checking him. Was there any thought of sending him to the hospital as a precaution, or is that something, another set of rules for that?
Well, when he was booked in and he admitted to using heroin, inmates are screened by the medical staff when they arrive, and he was screened, and at that point, the medical staff determined that they would just put him on the protocol of monitoring his vital signs every 8 hours, and it didn't appear that anything arose to the level of contacting EMS until the day that he was found unresponsive.
Okay, so obviously he was monitored, and he had actually recovered and looked like he'd been improving before he was discovered, right?
That's correct. After a couple shots of Phenergan, he seemed to be improving, and he was monitored every 8 hours by the medical staff, and then our deputies were also, when they would make their rounds on the pods, checking on him as well. And he was then found by the inmate at about 4 p.m.
Now, had he put up any resistance? Had he been a difficult prisoner? Had there been any physical confrontation with him or anything like that?
I'm not aware of any physical confrontations with Mr. Watts. As far as I know, he was compliant with everything, and he was just being watched for the heroin use.
Now, you know, heroin's a dangerous drug anyway. I imagine any time you get somebody who's taken drugs, there's some unknown factors that can happen with their health, right?
Yeah, that's absolutely true, and especially with heroin use on the rise as it is, it's becoming more and more popular because it's prevalent. It's pretty easy to get, fairly inexpensive, so we're seeing a lot of people more and more coming into the jail with heroin use, and you know, it's something that jail staff takes seriously, and they adhere to the policies that are set into place by the medical staff and by our jail.
Right, I understand. Okay, well, I'll tell you what, where do you go from here? Is there an investigation, or what happens from the Sheriff's Department's view?
Our deputies completed a report. They've turned everything over to the medical examiner's office. The medical examiner's office will now conduct an autopsy and make a determination from there.